How's it going, everybody? It's Academy Film Room, week 12 of the NFL season. The Cowboys getting ready to take on the Washington football team on Thanksgiving. And Isaiah Stanback about to break things down for you. I'm Kyle Yeomans. And Isaiah, the Cowboys got a win this past week against the Vikings, but not a ton of time to look back. You got to look forward with a short week like this. And one of the reasons why is because Washington can hit the deep ball. They're a big play threat waiting to happen.
Absolutely. And we've had our issues in the past, right? Earlier in the season, right? Not so much as of late, but earlier in the season, we had our problems with communication on the back end of our secondary. And I think Washington may be aware of that. So let's take a peek at some of the things that they did last week to capitalize on Cincinnati's inability to communicate properly. So here they are right here in a bunch set, lining up against Cincinnati. And earlier in the season, if you guys remember, we used to see this concept called an over route and a post route, right? And it causes some confusion back here on this man right here, the free safety. Let's see how they communicate this on this particular play. Boom, Alex Smith at the helm right there at the quarterback position. Boom, little play action and get the linebackers to jump up. As you guys can see it right here, Foreman, you have the over route coming here, which is going to try to grab the attention of this safety. What they're trying to do is get him to draw down to try to cut this off and make him think he's getting the interception, all the while this guy is taking the top off on a post route. Let's see how this thing pans out. Boom, Alex Smith sees it. Over route grabs the safety. They're going over the top right here with McLaurin. Easy play. Nice throw by Alex Smith, by the way, who's having a nice resurgence. We got to figure him out. But a great play right there by a man who kicked our butts last time we faced him.
Yeah, Terry McLaurin, the reception. That was actually not bad coverage the whole time, but that shows the skill that he possesses. He's questionable this week, but I think we'll probably see him on a Thanksgiving battle. But I think overall, you look at this, and it's something, like you said, the Cowboys have struggled with prior, and you can go all the way back. Let's go back into that film room time machine. We're going back to week 3 against Seattle. This was a very good way of looking at how the Cowboys have messed this up in the past.
Yes, and this is something that we have gotten better at, but we have to go back in so that we don't repeat the past. So right here, instead of a single safety, we had two safeties back here, sitting back here in a cover 4 setting here, not a cover 3, but very similar. What's Seattle in? Seattle's in a bunch set, and then we got a short split here. So let's see how this pans out. Over route and a post route. Let's see how we handle this situation back then. Go ahead, hit the play button for me, Kay. Boom, Russell Wilson, big number 3, on a play action once again, okay, and you see this tight split here, taking it to the over route with Metcalf, okay? This is Tyler Lockett right here. Look how close our safeties are. This is when we were having a lot of issues in terms of our ability to talk and say, hey, this is my responsibility versus yours, Kyle. All right, you stay over there, I'm gonna stay over here so we don't end up covering the same guy. Unfortunately, we covered the same guy here. So you guys see Metcalf going across right here on that over route. Boom, he sells it. Look at these dudes. These guys both jump up here. And look who's going over the top.
Wow.
Big Tyler Lockett, or really little Tyler Lockett, who goes out here for a big play. But it looks just like the play that we just saw from Washington against Cincinnati, meaning that we've shown this play in the past and our inability to cover it. And Washington just showed it last week that they have this in their playbook, something to look out for.
Yeah, you're going to look at it. And I mean, this was more broken from a Cowboys defensive perspective than Cincinnati's was broken. Yeah. And I think whenever you talk about it, there was Darrell Worley involved. Trayvon Diggs was beat on that play as well. The miscommunication is something that bit the Cowboys early. Luckily, they've had that communication better over the last 3 weeks. They've also had the running game better. If we switch to the offensive side of the football, we saw that against Minnesota. First 100-yard rushing game for Ezekiel Elliott this season, which is a huge plus for the Cowboys, and a big reason why was his patience.
Absolutely, and you know, old Ezekiel Elliott, the cornerstone of our team right now. All right, we saw a little resemblance of the early Zeke, right? Zeke from a couple years past, right? But now let's see how he is continuing to develop this year. We had some early fumbles, the thing that kind of threw him off his game. We had some offensive line woes, right? We had some musical chairs on the line. Now we have Zach Martin, our All-Pro offensive guard, moved out to tackle. We got the Connor Bros up there at guard, right? We got Big Looney in there, all right? And we got Irving that's playing tough. So we have our best 5 offensive linemen that we currently have on the roster, and let's see how these guys are making some moves and how Zeke is reestablishing himself as the lead dog on this team. Boom, we're going back here to a split set with Schultz in the backfield. Boom, snap the ball right there, pause. Everybody has a man. It's a little clustered right here, but you guys see Irving throwing somebody out the club right here. Man on. That's linebacker. That's Big Kendricks that gave us some issues earlier. And we got old Connor bro right here about to come out here and find him, but hit the play button for me, Kate. Boom, pause right there. We have a 2-way go where we could have went that way, but Zeke is very patient. Instead of taking the easy route, right, he was patient. He saw a wall of white. When you see the guys turn their back, you know that I have 600 pounds of grown man right there that's not going to allow somebody to come over the top. And all he has to do is beat Kendricks. You see him with a little burst, boom, hit the play button, coming downhill. And that's the last thing that these safeties want to see is number 21 coming downhill untouched.
And I want to see this from this other angle because I'm excited to look at the fact that Zeke's vision here to not only see the wall with Looney and Williams, but also not to kind of get caught up in the fact that Kendricks was coming across toward him. He was able to know that and bounce a little bit to the outside.
Absolutely. So as you guys see it right here, we just snapped the ball. Only person that kind of got thrown out the club a little bit was Looney, right? Looney got pushed back a little bit, but you see big 6'6 right here. You see Schultz looking up his man right here. So it looks good, right? We have over here where we're good in terms of Martin taking care of his guy. So man on, man on, man on. This looks like a great lane, right? Perfect. So as Zeke comes up, he has that patience. You see him take the little hop. But look at it, he identifies the fact that he has Looney right here and Connor Williams with their wall, walling these guys in, so he knows that he can bounce this thing out. And he has the confidence, right, that Kendricks is not going to catch him. That lets you know that Zeke is starting to get his swag back.
Starting to find that swagger, starting to find that rhythm and that pace as well. But whenever you have the Thunder, it's always nice to have the Lightning as well. And we saw that with Tony Pollard.
Absolutely. You know, it's OTP, all right? That dude has the juice that'll get you loose. And exactly with this offensive line that we now have instilled, he has even more confidence to approach the line of scrimmage with some tenacity. So as you guys see right here, boom, we're going up to a motion. Coming across, we're going to hit the play button there. All right, we have four down linemen, two linebackers, and a nickel back here. And this is exactly what you want to see. We have six guys to block six guys. Mm-hmm. And the only thing that he has to worry about is A, this safety, or A, this corner. Typically, when we're running the ball, so say we're running the ball up here, which we might do, very well do right here. Your job as a receiver, all right, Noah Brown out here, you're taught as this safety starts to find his way into the play, you leave the corner. Mm-hmm. Leave the cornerback, come down here, crack on the safety so that that Tony Pollard only has to worry about the corner who is the worst, typically the worst tackler on the team.
And has a bad angle.
So let's see if they actually execute the way in which you're taught. Hit the play button right here. All right, going through his checks. Yes, yes. All right. Boom, perfect, right there. Look at this right here. All the linemen have stuck their guys, right? We're gonna have the ability to work up to the second level. Everybody on the line of scrimmage is taken care of. Now your eyes go to the secondary. What's Noah Brown doing? He sees that safety trying to come in here, right? He wants to blow this play up. What's Noah Brown do? Boom, play button, comes in, does exactly what he's taught to do, seals off that safety, leaves the cornerback for Pollard, and this corner does not want the smoke. He doesn't want to deal with Pollard, and Pollard knows that he has that sixth gear. Boom, hit the play button. There he goes. He's gone. He's gone, and you're not going to catch that man right there.
And you see it from another angle again. I mean, this is something that you haven't necessarily seen. We've pointed out previously that if the Cowboys have a numbers advantage, it doesn't always work out in their favor.
No, it hasn't in the past, right? But again, this is our new offensive line, right? This is our week 12 offensive line that we're going into now. So you guys see these guys take care of business, hit the play button here. Boom, right there. Pause that button for me right here and scoot back just a little bit for me, Kay. Run it back. Boom, Schultz is doing a heck of a job right here fighting on this defensive end. And look at big 7-0, big all-pro Martin, giving him a little flipper right here. And he's giving him a little help to bump him outside to help him, but he's also working up to the second level. Everybody's consumed. Everybody's doing their job. And then you have receiver who is going in there and getting a block, not catching the ball, but getting a block to make sure that his running back has the best opportunity to hit this gas button right here. Changes gears and he's gone.
And I still don't know what that corner was doing out on the edge as well.
He didn't want the smoke.
That's
okay. He didn't want it.
Tony Pollard was coming barreling downfield. I wouldn't want to tackle him either. He's Isaiah Stanback. I'm Kyle Yeomans. That's going to do it for this week's edition of Academy Film Room.